So today's talk is also centered around yarn, which was introduced in this morning's talk. First, let me introduce myself. So I became an HBase committer in 2011. And so I have been working on HBase since. So if you use this search site, search-hadoop.com, you can find my name. So I work for Hortonworks. So as Zhijie and Jen introduced in this morning's talk, so Hadoop as the next generation platform for not just data crunching, but also for some multi-purpose platforms. So this talk is based mostly on Yarn, which is able to handle multiple types of jobs, such as a batch, interactive, online processing, and streaming. So I think some of the attendees here know or thought this talk would be about Hoya, which was the previous incarnation of this project. So Hoya initially was meant as HBase on Yarn. However, although that's a concrete use case, that's the use case is somehow narrow. So when submitted for Apache incubation, this project got renamed to Slider. So this slide mentions several goals for Slider. So namely, high availability, meaning the user application or service. So the following slides, I would use application versus a service interchangeably. So high availability, once deployed, the user service would always stay on. So regardless of node failure or say container failure, et cetera. And the second goal is to provide flexibility. So this is done through dynamic scaling. So I'll mention the operations later on. When there's a change in the cluster, for example, node failure, the slider app master would respond reactively to such changes and adjust the number of containers to maintain SLA. So. So through these objectives, our goal is to achieve optimized resource utilization in the cluster. So since Yarn has been introduced in this morning's talk, I don't want to spend too much time on introducing Yarn again. So coming to the use case of Hoya or HBase on Yarn, I can give you some background. So now at say large enterprise such as Yahoo or eBay, the cluster tend to be very big. It can consist of say for example, at eBay, when I was there, the cluster size can be say 500. Nowadays, people are looking at 1,000 node cluster, so that's commonplace. So with such a large cluster, it is expected in the enterprise that the cluster would serve a multi-tenancy, meaning say multiple departments or teams or projects would share the cluster. So this also applies to HBase. What people do 2 years ago was, for example, one initiative was to introduce a region server group. So in a large HBase cluster, say on top of HDFS, people can partition the region servers into groups. Say each group would serve say a particular project or department. However, we know that such arrangement is rigid, meaning the boundaries of the region server group is fixed. So when demand changes, for example, suppose this department reserved say 10 region server group. However, the business demand picks up. So how do we adjust to the changing business demand? I personally reviewed such a patch about 2 years ago, which wasn't adopted into Apache HBase. So looking backwards, I can see so there was a reason for that. And so Slider is trying to utilize the resource management capabilities from Yarn. And so this slide shows that so originally HBase, we all know, runs on top of HDFS. The second part shows that the scheduling of HBase Ranger servers or master can be somehow dedicated to the Yarn resource manager. Okay, so first incarnation, HBase on Yarn, on-demand HBase. So first, the user would come up with a JSON configuration, which is stored on HDFS. That is used to drive a cluster setup and configuration. So the use case is, as I mentioned, in a multi-tenant Yarn cluster. So Hoya can spin up multiple small HBase clusters dynamically. So this not only can serve, say, long-running kind requests. It can also be, say, a transient. After certain computation is done, the cluster is no longer needed, and the cluster can be shut down. So this reflects the dynamic nature of the HBase cluster deployed by Hoya. So we provide say the two operations. So freeze is. For example, after the computation, based on this HBase cluster is done, the freeze command is issued, and the cluster is brought down. And later, when say this department or project wants to use this cluster again, we can solve this cluster and bring the HBase cluster back to its previous state. In the JSON configuration, the user can specify a tuple corresponding to the HBase release that he or she wants to run. So this is customizable. So through this, more efficient utilization of the cluster is achieved. I think this slide was touched upon by Zhiji and Jen's talk, so I'll just briefly go over here. So in the Yarn cluster, so Node Manager is deployed on every server. Node Manager heartbeats to a resource manager to report health, and resource manager would schedules work over the cluster by allocating containers. Node Manager starts container, and Node Manager would monitor container health. So coming to Hoya, HBase, the client can create App Master. And then, so App Master is created in some container on some host. And then App Master would request containers from the resource manager. So here, so we have two nodes on the left and right hand side of the screen. So App Master deploys HBase Ranger server in a respective container. And there's another container on the same machine running App Master for HBase Master. So I'll come back to this copy later in subsequent slides, which is, say, how do clients bind to this newly created cluster? As I mentioned, in a multi-tenant cluster, there would be multiple instances of HBase cluster. So previously, we used a Zookeeper, shown by this icon in the middle. So HBase client would talk to a well-known Zookeeper cron to discover the cluster. And after that is business as usual. So the HBase client can talk to the HBase master and region servers to fulfill its work. So let's look at a failure scenario where one of the server is gone, and resource manager notifies application master of this disaster, and the app master would respond by looking at the requested number of region servers, and basically spin up another container which hosts a region server that restores the previous number of requested region server instances. So here, I want to bring up a concept of role. So here is a sample JSON specification. So there's a global section which specifies general globally applicable parameters for this application instance. It can involve, say, what you call a requirement, et cetera. And in the components section, so I want to introduce the concept of role. So for HBase deployment, there's a master corresponding to HBase master, and say there's RS or worker corresponding to a region server. So each role can have its own specific requirement. For example, normally in an HBase cluster, the region server carries the majority of the work, so it tends to consume a higher amount of heap. So the region server would request, in this illustration, would request higher amount of memory from the yarn. And so in the component section, the parameter value would override the global setting. So some of this API is covered in this morning's talk. So here, this slide illustrates how a slider uses the same code to handle flexing. This corresponds to the flex operation, what's failure handling. So the second method on containers completed is a method declared in AMRM client async abstract class. So it notifies app master of container status. So when, say for example, when a container fails, this callback would tell app master of the failure scenario. And this method, review request and release nodes, would look at the allocation status of for each role and trigger the addition or release of action if the desired number of role instances doesn't match the current count plus the pending count. So the first method of flex cluster is in response to user request of flexing. So the flexing can the flex operation basically adjusts the number of instances per role in this instance of deployment. So we can see the limitation of the first incarnation of this project. So first, as I mentioned in one of the previous slides, so Zookeeper was used as the a protocol or channel for service discovery or binding. However, this assumption may not be true. For example, a Storm, right? I want to deploy a Storm in the Yarn cluster. There would be a Storm application wouldn't have this discovery mechanism. Second limitation is that the configuration is static. This is related to the first limitation because, say, for multiple or small HBase clusters, the clients would desire some dynamic mechanism to basically to discover and bind to a respective HBase cluster. For example, we wouldn't want to share the same HBase cluster between the finance department and say engineering department. And the third one is the sole shutdown mechanism is a kill without warning. This is not desirable in certain scenarios. So for each service, so Java code needs to be written to facilitate a service provider that can communicate with the client and app master. So although a protobuf is pretty powerful, however, this limits the application for the usefulness to certain applications, because not all applications want to communicate using a protobuf. The last one is the client code is driven through CRI, but ideally we want the slider to be a back-end process, more in the platform as a service. So let's look at, so this is a fictional, however, so this is a fictional scenario. However, we would want to achieve this goal in the future. For example, we deploy a HBase cluster in this in the large shared yarn cluster, and then later on, some say, for example, Tomcat servers are deployed. So how do we hook up the Tomcat servers with the HBase cluster? So Slider is the current incarnation or the successor to Hoya. So we here. I list several goals. The first one is a unified packaging format. So ideally, this packaging format is some archiving structure that does not require root access for installation, which basically, so when you specify a deployment-specific root folder and say some tarball, et cetera, that should be all needed for packaging. Second of all is, as I mentioned a few times, service registration and discovery. So a later slide would touch upon in more detail. So basically, at the time of a deployment, the service or a user application would register with some registry so that the clients can discover this specific instance at runtime dynamically. So this is related to the propagation of dynamic configuration information back to the clients. So basically, in a shared cluster, for the multiple active, say, HBase masters would use different hosts slash ports, and we need to convey this dynamic information configuration back to the client. So CRI is still one driver, but however, the client API can be more diversified. For example, we provide a REST API. So the goal here is, with no code change, we can deploy applications over a yarn cluster. So packaging. So earlier I mentioned some, say for example, tarball format. To serve as the packaging format that deploys applications. This packaging format should involve some metadata and some template. For example, for HBase, it's required that HBase.router is specified. So such template would be embedded in the package. And there's some template logic that converts the disk configuration two scripts. So the first step, we use some simple Python scripts that start different components in different yarn containers. So in the future, it is desirable to provide two more functions, a snapshot. So the app master can send a snapshot command to the participants, basically requesting a snapshot of that particular runtime state. So the runtime state would say can be persisted to a HTFS, for example. And the second command is basically a graceful stop. So this is in contrast with the queue-only shutdown method. This applies to a HBase, where so if the region server is started through a bin slash HBase, there is a graceful stop that Slider can utilize. So, okay, so coming to service registration and discovery, there's a Jira for that, which is more general, Yarn-913. In YARN 913, Robert, by the way, the YARN 913 is still open. So there are several proposals. For example, Robert proposed the service generating both public and private keys at the time of the registration. And the public key would be kept through the discovery protocol. So as a general requirement, the service registration would require, say, port bindings along with some URLs to be published. Also some other configuration data. The configuration data would be specific to each service or application. And client API needs to be provided so that the user can find the targeted instance, retrieve the bindings, and other related data, so that the client can make use of the newly active instance. So this would involve a generation for configurations to be used a client side that can be template driven. We are also looking at some other mechanisms. For example, in a curator, there is the discovery server, which is built upon the JAX-RS protocol. So that's one possibility. The other one, maybe following the example of Hoya, is to utilize a zookeeper. Say, publish certain binding information on a subtree of a known zookeeper node. That is, this part is still under discussion. So sliders two, a brief summary. So currently it's a tool written in Java. It's driven by CLI. So the input to a slider is a cluster description in JSON format. The specification of the cluster involves options for different nodes, possibly zookeeper parameters. And so based on such input, we generate configuration. And the state of each container is persisted. So the supported actions are create, which corresponds to creation of the instance. So I mentioned freeze and solve previously. So flex is dynamically changing the number of participating components in the cluster. The user can also query existence of say any particular cluster. So after the cluster is spun up, the cluster state can be changed. The user can add or remove nodes, and so a change stays for application components. So here's a diagram in the traditional model wheel controller model for the slider app master. So as I mentioned before, so we are adding a web interface to a slider. We're also providing a REST API for the client. So each, so the provider can also provide a REST service. So the controller part is basically the app master and the slider engine that responds to events from the YARN layer. The provider is responsible for building up containers that is to be run in the on each by each node manager. So here's the model. So there are different types of data structure that we maintain. Specification normally consists of resources.json and appconfig.json. So resources.json has specification for requirement for the cluster, such as say the number of instances for each row. And AppConf has some more application-specific configuration information. So at runtime, the app master would rebuild a node map, and that is a model of the yarn cluster. And so a component map is mapping between the container and the component instance. There's also some transient data structure maintained at runtime, such as event history. So a Collider as a service. So here the application first builds the resources and appconf JSON specification. It queues the request to Yarn resource manager. So when it is when the resource manager launches Slider app master, the app master reads this configuration, perform some a template-driven transformation, and deploys components. This was mentioned in this morning's talk. So as Zhiji and Jian mentioned, Yarn 896 is a gigantic Jira involving several subtasks. So the app master restart facility has been built. So so Slider is able to accommodate this facility by reconnecting container to the restarted app master. Currently, we use some reflection code to detect whether such facility is supported. This is due to the support for Hadoop 2.2, where such facility is not present. Another concern is token renewal for long-running applications. Yarn uses HDFS dedication token for log aggregation, but for long-running applications, there's more token renewal needed. So in order to support launching an app master after the maximum lifetime of the dedication token expires, the resource manager needs some method to replace the old token with the new one. And so another related Jira is Yarn 445. This is about the ability to signal containers. So this would be used for the purpose of, for example, debugging. Another one is RM managed against scheduling. In certain use cases, for example, if the user requires, say, for example, 4 or 10 region servers to be spun up, if lower, if not enough region servers are created, the user task may not be able to execute. So we need GAN scheduling that guarantees a certain number of containers to be available before the app master can start the user application. Another one directly related to HBase is anti-affinity. So in a previous slide, I showed two region servers running in containers on the same server. Normally, that's not desirable because when the server itself is lost, we are losing two instances of region server. So anti-affinity hint would help the deployment of HBase cluster to spread more evenly across the cluster. So service registry was mentioned earlier. We also need to consider coexistence with MapReduce in a shared cluster. So we need to make I/O bandwidth a resource when scheduling this service. And we also need to monitor the I/O and network load at different levels, say at container level, application level. Etc. And so possibly we can make use of a C group to regulate the consumption of different resources in the cluster. So here is the status for Slider as of April this year. So initial agent has been coded. So this agent supports a REST API. Mostly the agent is used to interface with Ambari. So package deployment of HBase, Kumano, Ambari, and Storm is supported. There's the evolving support for hierarchy in the JSON configuration. Service registry is actively being worked on. I think the incubator proposal was submitted about a week ago. Yeah, that's mostly it. Any questions? Yes, so the question is, what about support for secure HBase deployment? Yeah, I think I forgot to specifically mention this part. So I think earlier in the year, so we added support for secure deployment. So yes, this is supported.
You can start a secure HBase.
Yes.
Yes.
So the question is
so in order to start a secure HBase cluster, you need to distribute KTAP files for the HBase master, right? So how would you do that?
Traditional secure HBase deployment relies on KTAP files, right?
Right. So does Slider support that?
Yes.
Okay.
Any other question? Thank you.
Thanks.